In 1964, Soviet astronomer Nikolai Kardashev proposed a method of measuring the level of technology advancements of a certain civilization, now known as the Kardashev scale. Kardashev based his scale on the unchangeable laws of physics and from the point of humanity. The original Kardashev scale proposes three types of civilization. Type 1. Civilization harnesses all the energy available on the planet and have complete control over all the planet's resources. Meanwhile, Type 2 civilizations have unrestricted access and usage to the host star's fusion energy, becoming interstellar. Lastly, Type 3 civilizations have taken a step further by controlling the whole galaxy's natural resources and all kinds of energy, as well as becoming intergalactic. Now, can you guess where in these three types of civilizations does humanity fit in? Surprisingly, none of the above. Humanity in our days is currently at type zero. While we can definitely control some aspect of our planet, it's not enough to warrant us to entry to the lowest echelon of the elite club of civilizations. Type 1. Remember that Type 1 civilizations require us to have a complete control on all of the planet's energy resources, which we don't. In other words, we're almost there, but not quite yet. According to Carl Sagan, humanity in the 1970s era was at type 0.7. Based on its given formula, we are currently at 0.73. So unless humanity destroys itself, it's likely we will reach the Type 1 classification before the current millennium ends. Physicist Michio Kaku thinks that we may be able to get there faster. With the advancements we are experiencing, he predicted that humanity may enter the Type 1 category in 100 years, making this century or so critical as it will determine whether we will move forward to the next stage of civilization or perish. Because we're yet to find life on other planets, and there's no way to actually know what life in Type 1 civilization is like, we can only speculate. Based on Kardashev's scale itself, we can imagine what it's like to live in a Type 1 civilization and beyond. So buckle up as we take a speed trip to the future. If humans reach Type 1 civilization. If humans manage to come to their senses and reach a Type 1 civilization, it's likely that we'll be living in a utopia-like world. By this time, we may have turned our focus away from fossil fuels to wholly to unrenewable sources of energy like solar, nuclear, and wind power. Aside from having the ability to harness all the available sources in the world, we will be able to avoid natural disasters like earthquakes, volcanic eruptions, tsunami, typhoon, and hurricanes, as we can now control them. Not only that, but also them to our advantage, from terraforming hostile environments, building transoceanic underwater nations, to create cities in the moon. But since we're still in the present, we suggest you to watch our video, a magnitude 9.2 earthquake. What awaits us? Links you will find in the description of this video. At this time, Type 1 civilization has already addressed the threat of climate change and is working to help planet Earth heal. We may also have progressed by leaps and bounds when it comes to medicine, having successfully found a cure for diseases that are incurable to us right now. In Type 1 civilization, humans have already visited other planets. Later on, we may be able to mine natural resources on other planets and use it for our own advantages. With all available resources at our disposal and the advancement of our technology, sentient robots and AI will live alongside humans at this time. But are we there yet? Nope, not yet. However, one of Type 1's defining characteristics is global communication and understanding. With the emergence of the internet and English as the international language, well, we are halfway there. The Great Filter. unfortunately, it's not time to celebrate yet. You see, there is an idea accompanying the Kardashev scale, like a shadow that positions civilization past through a barrier, aka filter, before they could go to the next level. According to this idea, all life must pass through these nearly impossible challenges that threaten their entire existence. In other words, these are events that stop civilization and species from going beyond their supposed technological limit. It's been suggested that before a civilization shifts from one type to the next, they must pass through the Great Filter. Succeed means that the survival of our species is ensured, and failing means we will be wiped out. Or, at the very least, we may have to start from scratch, like the idea of returning to the Stone Age after enjoying great technological advancements. While it's certain a depressed subject to tackle, what's even more disturbing is that the Great Filter hypothesis has been used as a solution to the Fermi paradox. If you haven't heard about it, the Fermi paradox seeks to answer the question, if there's so much likelihood of the life beyond our own planet, then where are they? Let us know what you think before we continue. Now is also the time to subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. The possible answer: the Great Filter. According to the Great Filter, there may really be life in other planets, but they were wiped out before they could advance even further. There were aliens, but they are gone. With humans being humans, there's a high chance that we may come to face to face with the Great Filter if we were to ascend to the next type of civilization. If we fail, we simply go extinct. But if we find a way to avoid the catastrophe, we may be able to go to the next level, just like a video game. Just no respawning this time. If humans reach Type 2 civilization. There will come a time when, even with all the renewable energy sources on our planet, our demands for energy will not be enough. Humanity will now look toward the most powerful energy source in the entire solar system, our host star, the Sun. Harvesting fusion energy from our Sun requires an immense resource to build the only structure capable of doing so, the Dyson Sphere. Dyson Sphere is a proposed hypothetical megastructure built exactly for the purpose of harnessing the Sun's energy. Dyson Sphere is so huge that it practically covers the entire star. In fact, Dyson Spheres have been used by astronomers in an attempt to find a Type 2 alien civilization. The Dyson Sphere concept may not be original to humans. If there's a more advanced civilization out there utilizing the same kind of megastructure. Thus, Dyson Spheres are regarded as possible signs of life in outer space. So far, there hasn't been a conclusive evidence. But back to what future looks like for humans, like if ever we reach Type 2. By then, space travel to other galaxies will become pretty common. We can already terraform other planets. Mars, then Venus, might be our first projects. We may even begin venturing beyond our neighborhood as we take our first steps in a colonized other systems in the Milky Way. This time, however, we may have to begin to shed our biological shells. Instead, it's likely that many of us have chosen to upload our consciousness to live longer than our physical forms allow us, virtually granting us high immortality. If humans reach Type 3 civilization. If we get lucky enough to reach Type 3 civilization, by this time, our species have started to spread throughout the galaxy and beyond. More importantly, we will be utilizing the entire energy and resources of our entire galaxy. Not only do we harvest energy of our home star, but also the stars of other systems in the Milky Way, with the possibility of harnessing even black holes. Intergalactic travel will now be possible via wormhole teleportation. As we gain control and understanding of subspaces, we can utilize it to gain faster-than-light communication speeds between interplanetary colonies. Speaking of which, post-humans and transhumans will likely the next step to our evolution. Our descendants may still retain some qualities of their Type Zero ancestors, aka us, but they are superior to us in almost every aspect. However, as humans in thousands of years have passed, our descendants will likely resemble less and less like us. Kardashev's scale stopped at Type 3. He may have felt that as far as our civilization can get advanced, or any species for that matter. However, as you may know, many people have picked up on this idea and expanded the list even further. But what could kind of civilization that have surpassed one controlling an entire galaxy be like? If humans reached Type 4 civilization. Type 4 civilization is the next step beyond the original Kardashev scale. As we go higher and higher in the levels of civilization types, the more it is difficult to grasp how advanced it can be. Basically, Type 4 civilization is when a species is able to control not just one, not two, but a multitude of galaxies and superclusters. With how vastly powerful a species can get just by controlling the fusion and exotic energy, plus resources of one galaxy, imagine how powerful they can get with the multiple galaxies in the palm of their hands. These galactic overlords have enough power to reshape entire planets, and even galaxies as they please. If humans have ever gotten this level, it's unlikely that we have retained any of our previous form. But believe it or not, Type 4 isn't even the highest possible level a species can attain. But what's more powerful than an eldritch-like galactic overlord? That's right, a godlike race so powerful that they can manipulate an entire universe. If humans reach Type 5 civilization. Type 5 civilization are so mind-blowing powerful, they can control everything in the entire universe. The universe is basically at the mercy, and they could bend it to their will. If the universe is infinite, the post-humans in Type 5 civilizations have already likely explored its vastness and have now become its old gods after millions or maybe even billions of years of evolution and advancement. It's either that, or we've become some Lovecraftian monster every other lower civilization folks are deathly afraid of. At this point, we can actually say we've lived long enough to become villains. Hold up, it's not over yet. But you're wondering, what in the universe is even more powerful than someone who rules the entire universe? Enter the rulers of multiverses. If humans reach Type 6 civilization. If humans reach Type 6 civilization, you might be starting to think this is getting more and more absurd by the minute, but bear with me for longer. Though unproven, the multiverse theory is still largely popular among many people. So, if a Type 5 civilization that is supposed to rule over an entire universe can be hypothesized, what about someone who rules over multiple universes and parallel dimensions? These are Type 6 civilization species, able to control and manipulate multitudes of universes. They are like the gods of a higher echelon. At this point, it's almost impossible to wrap our heads around the idea of beings being able to subjugate universes and possibly even its own gods. Now we're getting close to the top. Yes, there is still theoretically someone or something more powerful than Type 6 civilization. If humans reached Type 7 civilization. What is even bigger than the universe? A multiverse, if they exist. What is even bigger than that? Something that holds everything within it, including every other possible universe, timelines, and dimensions. Everything is encapsulated within. Every idea, every possibility, every reality. The very fabric of reality. Every god and every species. Time, space, and existence. The omniverse. The omniverse is a term used to describe the cosmos itself, the total sum of space, reality, and time. Beyond it, it's literally nothing. Now, this idea is so foreign and comprehensible to our current state of minds that it's even more impossible to grasp how someone or something could control it. At this point, it seems the word civilization doesn't describe it correctly. This type of civilization is all-encompassing, omnipotent, and omniscient. Instead, it's now a singular being, experiencing everything at once, all timelines, possibilities, and existence. The term God might be a more fitting word to call it. Type 7 civilization is the overlord of existence. It is literally the God of everything. However, at this point, even the idea of Type 7 civilization is a paradoxical. With our current understanding and mental capabilities, it's almost impossible to wrap our heads around these things. Even though the Kardashev scale is hypothetical, they still spark fun through experiments. So if you want to know the answer whether humans are capable of achieving a Type 7 civilization, honestly, there's no way to tell. Not yet, at least. What are your thoughts? Join in the conversation below and make your own predictions. Thanks for watching.